Hi guys, my name is Anurag, and in this video, I'll be talking about the electron, which is chapter 29 from the Leaving Cert Physics course. The name electron was coined by the Irish physicist Stoney. Thomson is credited with the discovery of the electron, and Robert Millikan is the man that calculated its charge in his oil drop experiment. These are some of the properties of electrons. Electrons are indivisible, negatively charged, have a mass of 1 over 1840 atomic mass units, which is 9.1 by 10 to the minus 31 kilograms. Their charge is 1.6 by 10 to the minus 19 coulombs. Thermionic emission is the release of electrons from the surface of a heated metal. This usually happens in most metals at around 800 degrees Celsius. Electron volts are a measure of energy, and they can be converted to the standard unit of energy, joules. You multiply the number of electron volts by the charge on an electron, which is 1.6 by 10 to the minus 19, to convert electron volts to joules. Cathode ray tubes were used in older TVs and computer monitors in the past. In medicine, it's used in ECGs, which stands for electrocardiogram. A cathode ray tube consists of a glass tube in which there should be a good vacuum so molecules and air don't collide with electrons in the cathode ray. There's a filament, an anode, a cathode, two sets of parallel plates, and a fluorescent screen. A low voltage is passed through the filament, which in turn heats the cathode. The cathode starts emitting electrons because of thermionic emission. Electrons accelerate from the cathode to the anode because of a high potential difference, and pass through the hole in the anode at a high speed. When they hit the screen, kinetic energy of the electrons gets converted to light energy. This is called scintillation. Cathode rays are streams of high-speed electrons moving away from the cathode. The properties of cathode rays: they travel in straight lines, cause certain things to emit light, which is called scintillation, produce high electromagnetic radiation called X-rays when they hit a metal with a high velocity. They can be deflected in electric and magnetic fields. They're invisible and they contain kinetic energy, which is energy that moving things have. After electrons pass through the hole in the cylindrical anode, they go through parallel plates with opposite charges. Cathode rays deflect towards the positive plate and away from the negative plate because they're negatively charged. The cathode rays go to the Y plates and the X plates. Y plates change the direction of cathode rays vertically, and X plates change the direction of the cathode rays horizontally. This allows the focusing of the cathode rays, and this is a principle that old non-flat screen TVs worked on. When a charged particle enters a magnetic field, it will always move in a circle because the force is always at a right angle to the direction of motion of the particle. Here's the question. Calculate the force on an electron traveling at constant velocity of 2.8 by 10 to the 7th power meters per second, which enters a uniform magnetic field of flux density 2.6 teslas at a right angle. Okay, here's how you solve this. The formula you use is F is equal to QVB, in which F is the force, Q is the charge, V is the velocity, and B is the flux density. Flux density is basically how strong the magnetic field is. You substitute all the values you have into F is equal to QVB. And the answer for the force on the electron is 1.16 by 10 to the minus 11 newtons. X-rays are discovered by Wilhelm Röntgen, and they're basically EM radiation of a high frequency. They're used in medicine to take pictures of internal structures, and in industry to detect flaws in products. In X-ray production, you heat the cathode so it emits electrons by thermionic emission. Then, electrons travel incredibly fast from the cathode to the tungsten target on the anode. Tungsten is used because it has a high melting point. As soon as electrons strike the tungsten target, 99% of kinetic energy is converted to heat energy, but 1% of energy is released as X-rays. The lead-lined chamber has an X-ray window, which X-rays come out of. Rays are focused by the angle that tungsten target is placed at. Okay. So X-rays are high-frequency EM radiation. They penetrate some materials and ionize some. They cause some materials to light up. Once again, that's called scintillation. And they cause photoemission. In most metals, because of their high frequency. They're, however, really dangerous because they can cause cancer. The photoelectric effect is the emission of electrons from the surface of a metal exposed to EM radiation of a suitable frequency. The energy of a photon is given by E is equal to hf, in which h is Planck's constant and f is frequency, measured in hertz. A photon is a packet of electromagnetic energy. The work function, which has the symbol Xi, is the minimum energy needed to remove the loosest electron from the surface of a metal. And for a given metal, the frequency below which photoemission won't occur is called the threshold frequency. The equation for Einstein's photoelectric law is HF is equal to Xi plus half mv squared. It states that the kinetic energy of the fastest moving electron emitted, as the difference between energy of the incident photon and the work function of the material. Each photon gives all its energy to one electron. A photoelectric cell is a component that conducts an electrical current when light of a suitable frequency is incident on its semicircular cathode. It's used in automatic doors and burglar alarms.